Today I'm going to be covering the Sega Virtua processor and looking at the research that has been undertaken so far to enable its use in homebrew. Before we get to the SVP itself, I first want to start by discussing the hardware at the top level. Cartboard consists of 128K of DRAM. The Sega SVP clocked at 23MHz and a 16MB ROM. The ROM is used by both the Mega Drive and the SVP, but the SVP may only access 128KB of the ROM at any one time. This is due to its 16-bit register. The SVP was recently decapped by Richard Castler from Richie's lab. Richard's decap confirmed a number of things regarding the chip that weren't 100% confirmed until now. Firstly, the decap has highlighted the real name of the chip as the Sega 160FS. This internal name had previously been seen on a dev kit sold on eBay about a decade ago. Sprite Mind's forum member Nemesis posted photos of the dev kit at the time, including a photo of the chip branded with the Sega 160FS name. The meaning behind the FS suffix of the chip is unknown, but its numbers point to the chip being a Samsung DSP in the SSP160X series. This ties with the SVP documentation unearthed in 2006, which directly references the Samsung SSP1601. The decapping has also highlighted that the chip was manufactured in South Korea. If we take a closer look at the imagery taken by Richard, we can see some of the internals of the chip. The first observation is the size of the chip package compared to the die itself. The die is tiny by comparison. If we scale further, we can see the makeup of the chip. The DSP, which is configurable to run code from ROM or RAM. 1K of SRAM, dedicated to storing variables, most likely chosen for its fast random access speed. 2KB of ROM data that was extracted by Javi just last year and contains some interesting data that we'll talk about later. Another 2K of SRAM that is dedicated to running code 3 times faster than from ROM. A clock circuit for internal timings, a vast sea of gate arrays, and finally the I/O that surrounds the chip. So now we've discussed the internals of the chip, let's go on to discuss what Javi has researched. Originally he planned to make an FPGA of the SVP, but he had difficulties in interfacing things with his Mega Drive. So he instead opted to make use of the SVP on an existing Virtua racing card. Javi started by designing an SVP development adapter board to allow him to substitute the original ROM chip in a virtual racing card. The board exposes the ROM pinout in an accessible way and enables other boards to be plugged into it. An accompanying board, the SVP EEPROM board, was designed to plug into the SVP adapter and enable custom code to be fed to the SVP from an EEPROM. You'll find that the boards designed by Javi featured the text "Designed under the sun of Cadiz." This was Javi's birthplace, situated in the southmost city of Spain. It's not usually associated with technology, so for him it was really important that it had a bit of a tech legacy. Once the boards were completed, Javi removed the Virtua Racing ROM chip from the cartboard and then soldered on the SVP development adapter board. He then plugged in the SVP EEPROM board. With the cart interface now working, Javi wrote some code to enable him to display the contents of the SVP's internal ROM on screen. He then painfully wrote down each line of the 2K of assembler stored in the chip's ROM before analysing it. Javi found that the code consisted of the SVP's boot code and an unused 3D library. He's presently working on the code to test this library. If you have any experience with 16-bit assembler and 3D coding, Javi could do with your help on this. Javi has documented everything he has done so far on his GitHub page, so if you fancy having a go at creating your own SVP game, be sure to check out the link in the description of this video. Let's hope with the work of people like Javi and Richard that one day we see people developing SVP homebrew, and when they do, I'll be covering it here. That brings us to the end of our SVP journey for now. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one.